Morning dear students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and watching our videos regularly. This is Full Kumari from Sri Vasishtha Vidyalaya.
Students, there is an important announcement for you that we have started our school website where we are uploading videos and assignments along with answer key. You can also find a link over there in which you can ask your queries. We are also conducting online test on the same web portal, and ebooks are also available on the same platform. Today we are going to learn social studies of standard 4th lesson 2 that talks about northern plains. So let's start. In previous videos, we have learned about northern plains in detail. Here in this video, we are going to cover fill in the blanks, match the following and answer the following questions. Our first exercise is fill in the blanks. The first point is the area drained by a river and its tributaries is called its dash. Students, we already have learned in previous video that the area watered by a river and its tributary is called its, let's check, that is basin. Now, the next we have the longest tributary of the river Ganga is dash, which joins it at dash. We all know that longest tributary of the river Ganga is, let's check, yes, it's Yamuna. And these two rivers, they join it at Allahabad. Yes, students. And you know, students, the meeting point of river Ganga and Yamuna is called Sangam, right? So let's discuss third point. The third point is the river Brahmaputra is also known as dash in Tibet. You know, students, that river Brahmaputra starts from Tibet. Yes, and in Tibet, the river Brahmaputra is known as, let's check, yes, that is Tsangpo. The river Brahmaputra is known as Tsangpo in Tibet. Now let's move to fourth point. Dash, Eid and Christmas are important festivals celebrated by people in the Brahmaputra region. You know, students, the states like Arunachal Pradesh, Tripura and Assam lie in the Brahmaputra region, and the festivals they celebrate are Eid and Christmas. Apart from that, what is the other festivals? Let's check. Yes, that is Bihu. Now let's move to the next exercise, that is match the following. So here we have column A and column B. So first we are going to talk about Satluj, right? We all know that Satluj is the tributary of river Indus. So I will match first with C. Now second we have Sundarbans. We all know that Sundarbans is the largest delta of the world. That is why I join second with D. Yes. Now, third one, we have Ganga Basin. We all know that Ganga and its tributary makes the area very fertile. That is why the area is most populated. That means Point 3, that is Ganga Basin, will join with A. Ganga Basin is the most populated part of India. And fourth we have Allahabad. Yes, Allahabad, we all know the meeting point of rivers Ganga and Yamuna. It in Allahabad. Yes. Yes, students, the meeting point of river Ganga and Yamuna is called the Sangam, and these rivers joins it in Allahabad. That means Sangam is there in Allahabad. Yes. Now let's move to answer the following question. We start with the first question, that is, which delta is also called the Green Delta and why? The Ganga Brahmaputra Delta is also known as the Green Delta. You know, student, this delta is known as Green Delta, and why it is known as Green Delta, let's know. First, have a look of this diagram. This is the picture of Sundarban Delta. Here, two mighty rivers, that Ganga and Brahmaputra, flow, and these rivers deposit sand and silt here in this region. That makes the area so fertile, and a large number of crops grown here throughout the year. That is why this area earned the nickname, right, student? That is its nickname, the Green Delta. Some of the crops that grow in that area are rice, maize, and pulses. Now let's back to the answer. The Ganga Brahmaputra Delta is also known as the Green Delta. This land is very fertile and looks green throughout the year. Many crops like rice, jute, maize, pulses, oilseeds, and wheat are grown here. Thus, it is called the Green Delta. Alright, students? Now let's move ahead to the second question. The second question asks to explain how the largest delta of the world is formed. Okay, now students, we already have learned the definition of delta, right? Once again, I repeat here about delta. A triangular shaped land formed by the deposition of silt at the mouth of river is known as delta. Yes, students. And if the question comes that what is the largest delta, the first thing comes in our mind is Sundarban Delta. Yes, students. Now back to the answer. The Sundarbans or the Bengal Delta is the largest delta in the world. It is formed by the silt deposit of river Ganga and the Brahmaputra at their mouths. Right? So let's move to the third question. The third question is, why the northern plains are ideal for growing crops? Name the crops that grows here. Now students, just look at the map. Now, here I have taken the northern part of Indian map. Students, you know, in northern parts, Ganga and its tributaries flow and makes the area so fertile by depositing sand and silt in that area. That is why the northern plains are ideal for growing crops. Yes. Now, let's discuss the answer. The northern plains are ideal for growing crops because they are very fertile. They are formed by sand and silt brought down by the Himalayan rivers. The crops grown here are rice, wheat, maize, etc. Yes, now let's move to the fourth question. Here we have to explain in brief the course of River Indus. Here we have to explain about the course of River Indus. Now students, just look at the map. Yes, here I have taken northwestern part of Indian map. And you can find here the River Indus and its tributaries. They are Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bees and Satluj. Right? You know students, these rivers form fertile land to western part of northern plains. Yes. Now let's discuss the course of River Indus. The River Indus and its five tributaries formed the vast fertile tract of the western part of the northern plains. All the tributaries of the River Indus and the Indus itself originates in the Trans-Himalayan region. Right students? Now let's move ahead with the next question, that is fifth. How the Indus River basin is important to us? As we know that River Indus and its tributaries formed the western part of northern plains so fertile. That is why we can say that agriculture is the main occupation in this region. Indus River basin is important to us because here land is very fertile. So agriculture is the main occupation of the people. The major crops grown are wheat, pulses, barley, maize, rice and sugarcane. It provides food to millions of people. Now, this is all about question and answer. Now it's time to have a map activity. This time in map activity, we are going to discuss about rivers of India. Now students, look at the Indian map. Here you can see River Indus and its tributaries that flows in different states of India, right? And you can also find River Ganga and its tributaries that flow in different states of India, right? Now first we are going to discuss about the three states of India falling under Indus River basin. Now let's check which are the three states of India that comes under Indus River basin. They are Punjab, Haryana and Himachal Pradesh. Alright students, so I have taken three states. They are Punjab, Haryana and Himachal Pradesh. Now next we have five states through which the Ganga River flows. Alright, here we have to find out any five states through which the Ganga River flows. Yes, we can see here Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand and West Bengal. These are the five states that I have taken through which the Ganga River flows. Yes, students. So this is all about math activity. I hope you have enjoyed today's video. Thank you and have a nice day.